Das sogar, ja.
Oh, here I am. Okay, there it goes. There it goes. Hi, everybody. All right, I'm hoping this is working. If anybody's on the Facebook, let me know if it's working. Hi. All right. Up with that, by all means, feel free to do that. And let's say hi, everybody. There's a chance a dog might come join us. I'm not sure. We'll see how that works. And there we go. Hi. Oh my God. I love seeing everybody, and if you're joining live on Facebook, feel free to send messages later so that I know. Again, if you guys have questions after this, I won't necessarily be able to answer them during the class. Just fixing a couple things. I have to mute everybody, sorry. But definitely send me messages so that I can make sure. I'm planning to try to do this as our Tuesday night, 7 p.m. every week until we get back on track, because I think I need it as much as you guys. All right, so all of that being said, I know there's a lot going on. I always tell you, you show up to this class however you need to. So if you're angry, if you're frustrated, if you're anxious, if you're sad, if you're happy, if you're just like, I don't know what I am, this is that class that you get to show up exactly where you are. And I'm sure there's a lot of extra of those interesting emotions right now. And guess what? You're allowed to have them. And hopefully through the course of this time together, we can settle some of that. We can get rid of some of it. It's the first day of spring. I'm just super excited about that. Things I'm grateful for right now, the weather, it's springtime. We still have this virtual connection. I'll take it. We can go for walks with each other at a distance. if anybody needs to go for a walk, I'm in. And the other thing that I'm really grateful right now, which has just blown me away, is everybody's kindness to each other is just, I find remarkable, because it's not what I was necessarily anticipating. And it's just been absolutely amazing how much people are going out of their way to say, like, what do you need? How can I help? You know, and try to keep everybody uplifted. So, you know, even showing up with all the other feelings, and I have them as well, I can find a few of those really awesome things going on right now to hold on to. So keep that in mind. So we're going to work on some grounding today, some letting go, and some really honoring that springtime of rebirth, right? Because with everything, that happens when we get to come anew. So again, if you're just joining, if you need to grab a couple of books to act as blocks, rolled up blanket, we're going to start settling in. So find your shape that you need to be in. You can lay down, you can sit up. If you're laying down, you can bend the knees and have the feet on the floor. Knees could knock in for support. If you're at home, I mean, you could prop yourself against the bed or the wall, whatever feels good for you. And just be here, just settle in. Notice how the earth feels underneath you. Find that as your first connection. Just noticing without judgment that sensation of the different places that your body touches the earth. Take a deep inhale through the nose. Open the mouth, release. And just let go. Allow yourself to be held here, to be supported. And notice the mind might be coming into this space, and the mind might be buzzing, might be busy. I often say you might be in that film loop where it's going around and around. So the invitation is to put all of those thoughts in a bubble, put them outside of this space. And on the next round of breath, for anything that's left, begin to just slow it down. Take a deep inhale here. And release. And then if there's anything unique for you going on, something I don't have the words for or the language, maybe you need to release. Maybe you need to energize. Maybe you're not sure what you need. On the next round of breath, we'll bring anything you need for this, for what is unique to you. Take a deep inhale and let it go. Then become aware of the heart space, Anahata chakra, glowing with green love, light, energy, awareness, joy, even fear for balance. All of these things together, letting them spin inside this heart space. Allow it with every round of breath to spin stronger and brighter within your chest, spinning clockwise. Feel its warmth, feel its energy. If you need to feel more connected, you can place a hand on the chest and another hand on that. If you're seated and you want to bring hands in Anjali Mudra, feel free. Whatever feels organic to you. And then begin to come to an intention. It could be for our time together. It could be for your week, your weekend, your month. It could be for your life. Anything at all. Our intentions will show up as real life manifestations. The universe will begin to give us the pieces that we need to allow these things to come to life. So let it spin and grow with every breath in your heart. Collective breath for intention. Deep inhale and let it go. Let it grow bigger than your physical being. And then taking three more rounds of soft, even breath just for you, for whatever you might need. And when you're you're ready, finding your way back up to seated. There's no rush. Take the time that you need. Hi, everybody. Welcome back. All right, so the first one, while simple to get into, maybe not so easy to stay in. So we're just going to do a toe stretch to start because we want to open up the soles of the feet. We want to be able to root and ground in our lives right now. So you're going to come to a kneeling place. Some of you, this isn't appropriate for, so maybe you just want to allow the tops of feet a little paddle out on the earth, maybe gentle rock and forth back and forth on the toes, but not staying in the pose, whatever feels okay for you. And this one I always do with you because I know how much it's just the most fun pose I ever put you in. So finding your way, curl the toes, sitting back, and here we go. Take an inhale. And let it go. I know you're smiling right now. I know for most of you, it's your favorite place to be. But seriously, imagine everything that we put our feet through. Just the privilege of us even having feet and the ability to walk and get around right now. So allowing everything in your foot to open, all that energy, all that baseline meridian energy, and just the pure simple connection of walking on the earth and the ability to being open, to being grounded with what's underneath you. Keep breathing. Take those inhales and exhales. See, I don't have to worry about the blocks getting thrown at me from this distance. I'm okay. Are you breathing? Almost there. Keep smiling, or don't smile. It's all right, wherever you need to be, it's okay. I know it feels like fire. Almost there. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let it go. And then tap the tops of the feet on the earth. I figured we'd get that out of the way first, right? And now we're going to come down into our backs for lung bench. If you have blocks, you're going to set them up in equal signs so that you have one underneath your head and one underneath the broad shoulder blades on your back. If you're doing the blanket, like I mentioned, you're going to have that long piece underneath your back. And you're going to lay down so that that rolled part is for your head. Bring the feet to the outer edges of the of your space, let the knees knock in, or bring the soles of feet together and let the knees knock out. Palms can face up. If you want to get into anything more deeply, you can clasp opposite arms and let them fall over the head. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again, and just let go. Asatoma sad gamaya, tamasoma jayatir gamaya. Rityor mamtam gamaya. From the unreal, lead me to the real. From the darkness, lead me to the light. From death, lead me to immortality. From Upanishads. So as we're in this place, this lung bench, we can allow more energy into ourselves. And this might be a time right now where you feel depleted. Maybe you're even sleeping a lot, but it's not feeling like you're recharging. So allowing this place, imagine the energy just filtering into your entire being. With every inhale and with every exhale, letting it fill you up. Change wears my sister's moccasins. He stays up late and wakes up early. He likes to come up quietly and kiss me on the back of the neck when I am at my drawing table. He wants to amuse people, and it hurts him when they yell at him. Change is very musical, but sometimes you must listen for a long time before you hear the pattern in his music. At the very center of our being is a great spaciousness that is untouched by sin and illusion, a point of pure truth which is inaccessible to the fantasies of our mind or the brutalities of our will. It's like a pure diamond, blazing with the invisible light of heaven. It's in everybody. And if we could only see it and integrate it, we would radiate a peace that would make all the darkness and all the cruelty vanish forever. Josie. Again, finding that breath. Breathing into the sensations. Allowing space to be created. Protection is sensible and artistic. In this country, we know her as a craftswoman. For her living, she makes capes and weaves shawls. She has only been a midwife. She notices that some people insist on wearing her garments far into the hot season. Others refuse to put a cloak on even when they are cold. Protection has lived in many kinds of houses. Always the walls are decorated with rugs and blankets from around the world. She has studied ancient architecture and the habits of butterflies and spiders. When the caterpillar is dying and the new butterfly is not yet to be born, it constructs a chrysalis. We also have this need. However, many of us are too proud or have forgotten how to go inside. Protection has learned from the butterflies how to make a chrysalis for the changing human heart. This being human is a guest house. Every morning a new arrival, a joy, a depression, a meanness, some momentary awareness comes as an unexpected visitor. Welcome and entertain them all, even if they are a crowd of sorrows who violently sweep your house empty of its furniture. Still, treat each guest honorably. He may be clearing you out for some new delight. The dark thought, the shame, the malice, meet them at the door laughing and invite them in. Be grateful for whatever comes because each has been sent as a guide from beyond. Rumi. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and just let go. When you're ready, gently bringing chin towards chest, maybe pressing elbows down to find your way up to seated. Once there, you can bring feet wider than hip width apart and let the knees gently fall side to side to open up in the hips. If you need to do a seated cat-cow, finding any organic movement you might need to release from this place. And then when you're ready, just pausing after taking those releasing movements and just noticing what has come up, soft gaze, closed eyes, just noticing without judgment what has come to visit, a thought, an idea, a sound, a smell. Maybe things were just quiet, maybe they felt busy, but we notice without judgment. When you're ready, slowly coming back. Our next pose is going to be sleeping swan. So many of you might know that as pigeon pose. And the first way you can do it, we're gonna start with our left leg behind and our right leg forward. So there's no pain in any of these yin postures in your knees. So if you get here and this is too much on your low back, your hips, your knee, we're gonna find another way to do this. If you're coming into the sleeping swan, you can place the blanket underneath the back shin if it's the extended leg that feels uncomfortable. And again, if the front knee is bothering you, this is not the shape for you and we need you to switch shapes. So another shape could be deer. Feet come to the earth. Let the knees fall to the same direction. You walk the hands in front of the front shin and then around towards the back foot. Sensation should be in this hip. That doesn't feel comfortable. You can come onto your back for figure four. So right foot would go over the left knee. You can lift that left foot off and hold behind the thigh. You can also do this against the wall so that the left foot would be against the wall. So any of those things are options. Make sure no pain in the knees. If you're doing the sleeping swan, when you're ready, you fold forward. If you need a book underneath your head, feel free. You can stack your hands into fists for your forehead as well. So gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and just let go. Especially in this place, as we have the third eye folding towards the earth, even if you have the head, the back of the head on the ground, imagine that space opening, being in touch with your intuition. I think it's important in this time to honor where you are and know that that can shift from moment to moment and it's okay. And feeling like that's okay. It's not a right, it's not a wrong. And many, if not all of us, are going through that sensation. Not something any of us might be used to. And then also notice the pelvis pressed towards the earth, either the back if you're on the ground or the front. Become aware of the root, our grounding chakra, this red fire that connects you down with the earth. On this first day of spring, imagine planting something tonight in this moment in this shape that you'd like to see grow. Everything has shifted, but the soil is still there. So what do you need to plant for yourself? What would you like to see grow? Allowing that to sink deeply into the earth. Mary Oliver writes, "There is a thing in me that dreamed of trees, a quiet house, some green and modest acres, a little way from every troubling town, a little way from factories, schools, laments. I would have time, I thought, and time to spare, with only streams and birds for company, to build out of my life a few wild stanzas. And then it came to me that so was death, a little way away from everywhere. There is a thing in me still dreams of trees, but let it go. Homesick for moderation, half the world's artists shrink or fall away. If any find solution, let him tell it. Meanwhile, I bend my heart toward lamentation, where, as the times implore our true involvement, the blades of every crisis point the way. I would it were not so, but so it is. Whoever made music of a mild day." You feel a lot of sensation here. Often our sensation is the unconscious mind having a conversation with us. So take a deep inhale and let it go. Allowing the breath to breathe through that, to release it, to soften around it. Continue finding that breath. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let go. If you're facing the floor, using the hands to walk yourself back up, curl the back toes, release the front leg behind you. You can do some cat-cows to release out, or any other shape that you might need, downward dog. If you're on your back, releasing the bind, hugging the knees in and release, hugging the knees in and release. If you were in deer, the knees can come up and you can gently let the knees fall side to side. Finding any organic release that you need here. We'll take three rounds of breath and move to the other side. So inhale, exhale for one. Inhale, exhale for two. Last round. And now if you plan to do sleeping swan on the other side, right leg will go long behind you. The left knee will come up. Again, you can have that blanket underneath the calf to help lift the back knee. You could also place something underneath the hip if you need it. Again, if this knee hurts at all, Please switch your shape. Again, you can do the deer pose, feet to the earth. Let the knees fall in the other direction. You'll walk the hands over the front shin, and then keeping an arc, keeping the spine long, walking the hands towards the back foot till you feel that stretch in that hip or coming down onto your back, finding the figure four, which you can also do against the wall. So finding any shape that feels organic for you. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let it go. Let go of the ways you thought life would unfold, the holding of plans or dreams or expectations. Let it all go. Save your strength to swim with the tide. The choice to fight what is here before you now will only result in struggle, fear, and desperate attempts to flee from the very energy you long for. Let go. Let it all go and flow with the grace that washes through your days, whether you received it gently or with all your quills raised to defend against invaders. Take this on faith. The mind may never find the explanations that it seeks, but you will move forward nonetheless. Let go, and the wave's crest will carry you to unknown shores, beyond your wildest dreams or destinations. Let it all go and find the place of rest and peace and certain transformation. Dana Faltz. Again, where's the sensation? Find the breath, take a deep inhale, and just release. Notice the grounding of the pelvis into the earth. If you're facing the earth, or if the low back is pressing into it, come to that root chakra. Allow it to fire up. Take a deep inhale. Release it out. Allow yourself to be into that soil, planting the seeds of what comes next, allowing the idea that on this day, this beautiful spring day, that things can grow, that things will grow, that the seeds you plant will blossom. I beg you to have patience with everything unresolved in your heart and try to love the questions themselves as if they were locked rooms or books written in a very foreign language. Don't search for the answers, which could not be given to you now, because you would not be able to live them. And the point is to live everything. Live the questions now. Perhaps then, someday, far in the future, you will gradually, without even noticing it, live your way into the answer. Rilke. Judgment does not like many people, but he loves a few very much. Although he is arrogant, he is not nearly as confident as others assume. He does not quite know how to handle all his insight, so people get the wrong idea. He is not ruthless, but steady and obsessed by his search for the truth. Stay with your breath. Allow it to soften where the sensation is. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let it go. If you're facing the earth, allowing your hands to help you walk back up, curl the back toes, release the front leg back, finding any organic release, cat-cow, down dog, a mini flow. If you're on your back, you can release the bind, hug the knees in, make circles on the sacrum. And if you're in the deer, you can bring both feet to the earth, let the knees just fall side to side. Once you've found your organic release, finding a pause, soft gaze, closed eyes, and again, just noticing what has come up. And noticing without judgment. If things are very busy, if things were quiet, maybe you remembered something from long ago. Maybe you were just flying everywhere all at once. But notice these places without the judgment. When you're ready, slowly begin to come back. Our next pose will be caterpillar, which is a forward fold with our legs out. So the blanket can be helpful here to sit up on the edge so you can unfold it if it's still rolled, if you were on it from our lung bench. And you can just take an edge of it and sit not completely on it, and legs will go long, because you want to try to get the low back to shift forward so that this isn't the caterpillar. And if your hamstrings are screaming, then bend the knees and fold. You can also put a blanket underneath the knees. You could sit up, you know, on a book, as long as you're not going to ruin it, because our books are precious. So finding your way. If for any reason this feels awful, another option for your forward fold could just be butterfly, soles of feet together, knees knocked out. If that is also not something that feels good, put your legs up against the wall. Enjoy something a little more restorative and supportive. If you need support right now, honor where you are and take that. So finding any place that you need to be. So gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let go. If you're in the caterpillar, the only other thing I didn't mention is you can take some books and stack them underneath your forehead, or take a pillow and stack the books on top of that, or just your hands to give yourself some support. We are scared of the unknown, the purpose we have no thoughts on, and the purpose we do. So we live, and we die, and we heal. We sing and dance and live and laugh, and we dream and we wonder. We believe the truth and the lies, and we live as ants, unaware of the danger of the burning sun. We share and we laugh and create and destroy. We kill and we starve and burn and die. We poison and hurt and hope and live again in a cycle of never-ending stories. We believe in God or gods or spirits, beings of infinite power and life, the center of existence, and we follow their rules and footsteps. We believe in heaven and hell and reincarnation, being part of a never-ending cycle. few names and words, yet millions in the world, at least the one after death. Death. We are afraid of existence, of what comes after, so we tell ourselves to follow a path, and that at the end of the path, death is inevitable, yet we continue on in different forms. We grow and learn and educate and share. We share. We share what is known, what is not, what is disappearing, what is lost. And we learn of the past, of now, of what is next, and what is in between. By Nika. As you're folded here in any shape that you are, you're bowing to yourself, honoring yourself, releasing everything from that root up the spine, from that root through the crown, that connection with the universe, with everything, with all that is. Again, having that sense of grounding, breathing into that root, that chakra at the base of the spine, allow your breath to fire it up. Imagine that space glowing red, having vibration, vibrating into the earth underneath you. On that next round of breath, allow that inhale and exhale to pull that breath up the spine through the crown. Feel the energy as you open, as you connect. Your life is your life. Don't let it be clubbed into dank submission. Be on the watch. There are ways out. There is light somewhere. It may not be much light, but it beats the darkness. Be on the watch. The gods will offer you chances. Know them. Take them. You can't beat death, but you can beat death in life, sometimes. And the more often you learn to do it, the more light there will be. Your life is your life. Know it while you have it. You are marvelous. The gods wait to delight in you. What you missed that day you were absent from fourth grade. Mrs. Nelson explained how to stand still and listen to the wind, how to find meaning in pumping gas, how peeling potatoes can be a form of prayer. She took questions on how not to feel lost in the dark. After lunch, she distributed worksheets that covered ways to remember your grandfather's voice. Then the class discussed falling asleep without feeling you had forgotten to do something else, something important, and how to believe the house you wake in is your home. This prompted Mrs. Nelson to draw a chalkboard diagram detailing how to chant the Psalms during cigarette breaks and how not to squirm for sound when your own thoughts are all you hear. Also, that you have enough. The English lesson was that I am is a complete sentence. And just before the afternoon bell, she made the math equation look easy. The one that proves that hundreds of questions and feeling cold and all those nights spent looking for whatever it was you lost and one person add up to something. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let go. Using the hands, help yourself walk back up. Maybe bring the hands under the thighs to help the legs back up. Maybe allowing them to fall side to side. Maybe you need a downward dog or a seated cat-cow. maybe even a reverse table. So finding any organic shape that allows you to release from this place, from this pose. And then when you're ready, pause. And just notice again without judgment what has come up. When you're ready, slowly begin to come back. Our next pose is going to be praying mantis. Lots of versions of this to help it be accessible for whatever is okay in your body. So the books can come in handy right now. You'll be placing them under about the elbows and the forearms so you can take the stacks of books or whatever you have to help you. And then placing the arms on them, hips over the knees, and then allowing the heart to sink towards the earth. Palms of hands can come together towards the back of the neck. So that's variation one. Another variation would be child's pose legs, where the hips are sunk low and the arms are over the books. You can also roll that blanket very tightly, more bolster-like, if you don't have books. Hoping everybody has some books at this point. So arms could just stay out, hips are low. You could do this without the books, and you can do Anahata Asana, puppy pose, where the arms are wide and you sink your heart down. Again, hips over the knees, or you can take a more child's pose variation and forehead is coming towards the earth. You can also put a book underneath your forehead. All right, lots of options. No pain in the knees. Anything hurts too much, play a little bit by changing where you have your knees and your hips. You're looking for the sensation underneath the armpits and in the chest mostly. That's where we want to feel it, to open up that heart space. So if it's all feeling pain in the knees and the hips, we want to work more on this and opening that heart right now. All right, gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let it go. Allowing that heart to be open to the earth. Pablo Neruda writes, "Now we will count to 12 and we will all keep still. For once on the face of the earth, let's not speak in any language. Let's stop for 1 second. And not move our arms so much. It would be an exotic moment without rush, without engines. We would all be together in a sudden strangeness. Fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales, and the man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. Those who prepare green wars, wars with gas, wars with fire, victories with no survivors, would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade, doing nothing. What I want should not be confused with total inactivity. Life is what it is about. I want no truck with death. If we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving, and for once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt this sadness of never understanding ourselves and of threatening ourselves with death. Perhaps the earth can teach us, as when everything seems dead and later proves to be alive. Now I'll count up to 12, and you keep quiet, and I will go. From the power deck, centering. Never leave your center. Count your bad points as well as your good. What is good and what is bad are most often purely relative. If you sense a weakness within yourself, explore it. It may become the source of your greatest strength. As you sit like a sacred Buddha amid the pandemonium of your life, always remember that the situation or person who has the ability to upset you the most, to pull you off center, is your greatest teacher in the process of centering. Such negativity can become your addiction. Center yourself in your power and release your need for constant distraction from your center. Contentment has learned how to find out what she needs to know. Last year, she went on a major house cleaning spree. First, she stood on her head until all the extra facts fell out. Then, she discarded about half her house. Now, she knows where everything comes from, who dyed the yarn dark green, and who wove the rug, and who built the loom, who made the willow chair, who planted the apricot trees. She made the turquoise mugs herself with clay she found in the hills beyond her house. When contentment is sad, she takes a mud bath or goes to the mountains until her lungs are clear. When she walks through an unfamiliar neighborhood, she always makes friends with the local cats. Wherever you feel the sensation, make sure you breathe. That breath is your superpower, especially when things do feel uncertain. Allow that breath to ground you as you press your heart to the earth, joining heartfelt intention with the soil, with planting the seed. Gather the breath deeply and release, inhaling once again and letting go. When ready, finding your way into any shape that is an organic release for you. Maybe you need a child's pose with your arms resting over the thighs. Maybe you need a tabletop and finding some cow and cats. Maybe you need to kneel and bring hands behind you, clasp them and lift the heart to the sky, releasing. And then maybe bringing them forward, interlacing fingers and releasing hands to sky. So finding any type of organic movement that feels good. And then pausing. And just noticing again without judgment what has come up for you. Not a right, not a wrong. When you're you're ready, slowly come back. We're going to come down onto our back for bridge pose. So this would be a great time for one of your books if you don't have a block. If you have a block, you're going to place the block underneath your sacrum. Like I used the other night, I'm going to take my Edgar Allan Poe book and use that to show you. So feet come to the earth, lift the hips to sky, bring your block underneath you or your book. Palms face up to receive from the universe. If you feel like you want to be grounded right now, then turn the palms down, allowing yourself to ground down more. And if anything feels uncomfortable about this, you could just be on your back with nothing underneath the sacrum, knees bent, feet on the earth. So gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and just let go. Heart still opens here. So allow that intention to spin, to find life, to find energy. Today the sky saved my life, caught between smoked rum and cornflour. Today, there is a color I can't name cruising past the back door. It is the idea of color. Cloudscapes evaporate like love songs across lost islands, each a small bit coin of thought. Today, I am alive and this is a good thing. Clams in the half shell, a lemon rosemary tart. I live in the day and the day lives past me. If I could draw a map of the hours, a long horizon would travel on indefinitely, a green backlit thread. The sky, it is never the same. It is sour milk and whipped cream, a sketchbook and flour-dusted jeans. Today, I am in love with the sky. It doesn't care if my father is dead or that I live by myself with his Masonic watch. I sew time with my mother's button jar. I've improvised my life. Let the sky pull the strings. Tonight, I'll borrow the golden ladder from the orchard, travel from this sphere into the next, and expunge the leftover sadness of the hemispheres to move beyond the beyond, which is here, present, alive in this hyacinth room. Time leaps over itself, after and out of the tangled past, over shadows of weather, falling across the back window, to forgive one another, to try once more to live it right. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhaling once again and let go. You can hug the knees into the chest very carefully if you're on a book, because it's probably a little more unstable than a block. So either press the feet into the earth, lift the hips, remove the book or the block. If you feel stable, you can just hug the knees in and release. Hug the knees in and release. Make some circles on the sacrum 3 times in one direction, 3 times in the other. And then we're going to do legs up the wall. So just extending the legs into the sky. If you have a block or a book and you would prefer to have that underneath the sacrum, feet back to the earth, lift the hips, place the block or book underneath you. And then very carefully, depending on what you're on, extending the feet to the sky. And you do not have to have anything underneath you. Great place to be to just allow everything to flow back down to the heart. To get clean, to recharge. So gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let it go. Always one of my favorite poems to read, so I think I read it almost every time. And the great mother said, "Come, my child, and give me all that you are. I am not afraid of your strength and darkness, of your fear and pain. Give me your tears, they will be my rushing rivers and roaring oceans. Give me your rage. It will erupt into my molten volcanoes and rolling thunder. Give me your tired spirit. I will lay it to rest in my soft meadows. Give me your hopes and dreams. I will plant a field of sunflowers and arch rainbows in the sky. You are not too much for me. My arms and heart welcome your true fullness. There is room in my world for all of you, all that you are. I will cradle you in the boughs of my ancient redwoods and the valleys of my gentle rolling hills. My soft winds will sing you lullabies and soothe your burdened heart. Release your deep pain. You are not alone and have never been alone." Linda Ruther. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let it go. If you have something underneath you, bring the feet down to the earth, lift the hips, remove the block or the book. Then hug the knees into the chest and release. Hug the knees into the chest and release. Make circles in the sacrum 3 times in one direction, 3 times in the other. When ready, allow the knees to fall over to the right, arms open in a T or cactus, looking over the left shoulder. And gather the breath deeply and release. Inhaling once again and just let go. Allow the eyes to soften or be closed here. Noticing sensation within, allowing it to soften. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and let go. Bringing the knees back to center, hug them in and release, hug them in and release. Make the circles in the sacrum three times in one direction, three times in the other. And when ready, allow the knees to fall to the left. Arms open up into the T or cactus, looking over to the other side. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and just let go. Again, noticing where you feel the sensation. And then allowing it to soften. Giving yourself permission to release just a little bit more. Gather the breath deeply and release. Inhale once again and just let go. Bring the knees back up to center, hug them in and release, hug them in and release. We're gonna set up for Shavasana. So finding anything you wanna place underneath your knees, like the pillow, a blanket, if you need to place a blanket over you, if you need to turn down your lights, I won't be doing, I'll talk you down into your space, but then I'll be quiet till I bring you back up. So I'm still here, so don't worry, I haven't disappeared, but maybe you'll notice the sounds around you. Maybe you'll be able to tune out and go a little deeper. So again, if you're feeling any lower back discomfort, it's can be better to bend the knees, let the knees knock in. Feet might be hip width or a little further apart. You could also bring soles of feet together and let the knees fall out, or even place the legs up the wall, whatever feels organic and restful for you. So Shavasana, this is our final pose, an opportunity for our body to bring everything back together that you've just done for it. Not meditation, just pure relaxation. So take a deep inhale and release out. The body to become heavy into the earth, allowing yourself to be held and supported. The heels be heavy, the legs heavy, the hips be heavy, the entire back body, the back of your head. Allow the front body to be held by source and sky above. Begin to soften in the brows. The eyes are heavy. Even wiggle the bottom jaw back and forth to release any final tension. Tongue is heavy, mouth relaxed. If you're having a thought, let it pass. Another one comes in, just let it go. Enjoy these final moments, and I will call you back. Slowly begin to come back, bringing breath back into your beautiful body, joining the spirit with the physical, wiggling fingers and toes, nodding head side to side, maybe even bringing the arms overhead for a morning stretch to bring the body back. If where you are is divine, then the invitation is to remain there. If ready, hug the knees into the chest, rolling over onto the right, pausing here, a place of beginnings, knowing all things from this moment forward are possible. Asato ma sa gamya, tamaso ma dhyatir gamya, mrityor mamtam gamya. From the unreal, lead me to the real. From the darkness, lead me to the light. From death, lead me to immortality. When ready, coming up to seated, closed eyes, soft gaze, reclosing them once there. And then pausing here, just noticing what has shifted, what has changed. Hopefully we filled what was empty and emptied what was full. Gathering hands at heart center, palms pressed together, come back to intention set at the beginning. Taking a deep inhale here through this heart space. Open the mouth and release, allowing that intention to fly off to the universe, knowing it will be heard. It was an honor and privilege to practice with you today. We bow our head to our hearts together. We say, Namaste. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. Thank you, Facebook. Thank you, Zoom. Thank you, Ease community and my extended community and other teachers who have come into the space. I'm honored and grateful that we have this ability. Hopefully, we'll be reunited soon. If you have feedback for me, email me, text me, ask me questions. I already know in my head other places I need to be clear in how I communicate things. But if something didn't land for you, I might not know. So tell me so I can say it better when we meet next time, because I'm not able to see you, so all of you. So I might not be saying the things you need to hear to help you to get in and out of your poses. I love you all dearly and deeply, and I miss you. Words don't have the amount that I miss you all, and I'm so grateful that we can show up in this space. So thank you so much for being here. Enjoy the weather, enjoy everything that you can, and know it's okay to be any place that you are, and I will see you next time. Namaste, everybody. Thank you.